everyone. So for in this video, we're going to be doing a exercise that I've developed, which is pretty much an extension of my other video, which was one of the best like bass exercises that you, or one of the best exercises you can do for on bass guitar, which was root third and fifths. So that would be going through and weaving through root third, fifth, third root, and then going up and down that way. And it all stays diatonic within a key. This one is going to be diatonic sevenths arpeggios. So again, we'll stay in the key of C, just to keep things simple, so it's all just the white keys. You don't have to worry about any sharps or flats. But the patterns are really what you're going after for this, because once you see the patterns, then you can move them anywhere you want on the neck, and it'll help you create new bass lines and solos and things like that to be more creative in general. For this one, you want to just start off by just going forward in each of the patterns, and then worry about going backwards and forwards and intermingling them, and just experiment with it as much as you can. To show you as an example what I'm talking about, I'm going to go through and I'll play all of them just going forwards for this one. So it's going to be in the key of C. So if I was playing C major 7th arpeggio, it would be root, 3rd, 5th, 7th right there. So C, E, G, B. Now, going to my 2, which would be D, that is a minor chord. So playing through this one, now we're talking about root, flat 3rd, 5th, flat 7th. So D, F, A, C. Now, going through this again, now the 3rd, being E, is a minor as well. This is what, if you don't know your numerical system for your chords and whatnot, this is a really great way of kind of maybe like practicing it or even learning it if you haven't been exposed to it before. Where you're 1 major, 2 minor, 3 minor, 4 major, 5, it'll be a dominant, 6 minor, 7 is a half diminished, and then back into your 1, which is your major again. So instead of me going through and explaining each one of these, I'm just going to play through all the patterns, and then we'll talk about being able to weave through this, and I'll demonstrate that as well. So here is just going forwards. So that's just going forwards with each one of them. And as you see, like I'm keeping everything nice and even through the whole thing. Root, 3rd, 5th, 7th, root, 3rd, 5th, 7th, so on and so forth. Now, to spice this up and to make it a little more interesting and also work on the dexterity for your left hand and your right hand, just kind of making them coordinate better, weave in between these. Here's the example. So go up C and then down D. I would go C, E, G, B. And now I'm going to go to the 7th of the D minor, which is C. And then down to A, the 5th, F, the minor 3rd, down to D, which is the root for the minor 2. Then you do this for all the patterns. Now, if you notice when I was doing the first example, I went from the 5, which is the dominant, I slid up to A to be able to continue the pattern. So dominant to minor. And then when I get to the B, this is the only one that's outside of like the two, or like the major or minor patterns with your half diminished, where we're doing root, flat third, flat fifth to a flat seventh. Obviously full diminished would have been a double flat seventh, but we're just staying diatonic in the key of C, half diminished. And then it goes back up to C. So here it is, weaving up and down through the exercise. Have fun with this, experiment with it on your own, develop your own exercises out of this as well. This is a great tool to be able to try and like build your dexterity and creativity for bass lines. So enjoy, guys. Check it out.